anhydride. Anhydride is this function group, C double bond O. Suffix for this functional group is anhydride is anhydride forms by the combination of two acids like CH3 C double bond O OH
Sir, only carboxylic acid.
Right? Two carboxylic acid. When you heat this, then dehydration takes place. Water molecule goes out. One acid gives H plus and another molecule gives OH minus forms H2O. This carbon and this oxygen combines and this forms CH3 C double bond O O C double bond O CH3. This is the molecule. Right? It is an anhydride. Okay? Anhydride. So anhydride forms by the combination of two acids. Okay. We can have same molecule or different molecule also we may have, right? So first of all, we'll see in this one only the carboxylic acid, the nomenclature of carboxylic acid is which is nothing but C double bond O. OH functional group we have. And in this also we start numbering from this carbon atom. The carbon atom of the functional group. Okay? So we'll start numbering from the carbon atom of the functional group. So if the molecule is this HC double bond OOH, for this you write down the suffix. Suffix is for carboxylic acid, suffix is oic acid. Suffix is oic acid. So we have only one carbon present here. Right, because we'll start numbering from this carbon atom. Only one carbon atom, so the name of this compound is methanoic acid. Methanoic acid, okay? If you have CH3, C double bond O, OH, one, two carbon atoms, the name of this compound is ethanoic acid.
Anhydride can only be a suffix, you can't have it.
It is a suffix, you'll have a suffix.
This one will be fixed.
We'll discuss that. After this, we'll discuss that polyfunction, what happens. Sometimes we'll take alkoxy, we'll discuss that.
Would this be called butene
anhydride? I'll come to this. First, we'll do this and I'll come back to this.
It's a
bute-2-enoic
acid.
Bute-2-enoic acid. 1, 2, 3, 4. Name of this compound is bute-2-enoic acid. A double bond is present at second carbon. 2-enoic acid. Okay. What is the name of this compound?
It's a 4-chloropentanoic acid.
Okay. So carboxylic acid like nitriles, acid halide, okay, other aldehyde, other functional group that we have done. Similar to that, we have to start numbering from the carbon atom of the functional group, and the suffix is oic acid. Now to number to name this anhydride, since this anhydride is formed by two ethanoic acid, right? Ethanoic acid and ethanoic acid. So name of this compound is ethanoic anhydride. Right, it is formed by ethanoic acid. Name of this compound is ethanoic anhydride.
Is there a space between oleic and acid?
No.
Two
ethanoic acid, so it is ethanoic anhydride. Okay, we'll just count the number of carbon atom. Anhydride means this group, right? The name of this compound is ethanoic acid. Suppose we have two different group present, then we'll write. We'll take one example and we'll tell you. Okay. Sometimes they also ask this question: what is the original molecule with which this anhydride has been formed? Okay. So what you have to do? This bond you have to break. What you do here? Just write down HO and H like this. Okay? This bond you have to break, write down H2O. And you break this bond, and you break this bond also. You can break this bond also. Any one of the carbon oxygen bond you break. Carbon and all the bond you are breaking, you see these two atoms, which one is more electronegative? Oxygen. So the more electronegative atom goes with the less electronegative atom. You have to consider the bond that you are breaking. This carbon-oxygen bond you are breaking, oxygen is more electronegative, and these two bond you are breaking, oxygen and hydrogen, oxygen is more electronegative. So the more electronegative atom here goes with less, and the less electronegative atom goes with more. So the compound here, it is what? CH3, C double bond O, OH, CH3, C double bond O, OH. Okay, we'll take some more examples and then you'll understand. So suppose the molecule is this, CH3 C double bond O, O C double bond O, H. What is the name of this compound?
So how do you name it if the two are different?
That's what. So first of all, tell me, what are the two acid we have with which this molecule has been formed? What will do? H and OH, right? So this bond will break, suppose. This O will take this H, this carbon will take this OH. So the two compounds are what? CH3 C double bond O, OH, and HC double bond O, OH. This is ethanoic acid, this is methanoic acid. The name of this compound will be ethanoic methanoic anhydride. Ethanoic methanoic, alphabetically we'll write. Ethanoic, methanoic, anhydride, alphabetically we will write. Okay, just we count the number of carbon atom this side and number of carbon atom this side and alphabetically we will write. Only one carbon atom, methanoic, two carbon atom, ethanoic. Got it? Okay, so you don't have to write down these molecules always. Okay, number of carbon atom this side and accordingly you can write down the name. CH2, C double bond, HC double bond O. What is the name of this one?
So do we have to write the two because then it can't be at first?
So in this case is not required. But suppose other molecule we have, then you have to write down. Ester. Ester is C double bond O, OR.
So is there a space between
oic
and anhydride?
Oic
and anhydride, is there a space?
We don't write this.
Continuous
to write.
So is it all just one bond?
Yes.
Just one bond?
Yes.
So even with acid, it's just one bond?
Yes, we'll write continuous. There's no, you know, capital letter in between. Anhydride. Yes. Suffix is alkyl alkanoid.
So which group is the alkyl? Is it this R?
This R is alkyl.
Okay.
An alkanoid will ride from this part. Okay, alkyl alkanoid. Write down the name of this compound, CH3 C double bond O, OET.
So is there any rule that states that we have to start counting from a certain carbon?
See, in this part, we always start counting from this carbon, 1 and 2. Okay. And we always write down this part first. If it comes alphabetically, fine. If it won't come, then also we'll write down the alkyl part first, and then we'll write alkanoid.
So,
okay?
So the numbering will be separate, right?
Yeah, here yeah, this will be separate, this will be separate. But this part will write first. Like you see, for this one, it is ethyl, right?
Yes.
Ethyl ethanoid. This one is methyl propanoid. Okay? This one is. It is 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Right? Or if you do this one first, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So you see here, it is 1 chloroethyl. Right?
Yes.
Chloroethyl also you can write.
And 3 bromo butane.
See, 1 chloro and 3 bromo.
Yeah.
So we won't write this 3 bromo first and then 1 chloro. We won't go alphabetically. First we'll write this part. So name of this compound is 1 chloroethyl. Then 3 bromo. 3 bromo butanoid. This one, again, this part will write first. So 1 bromo ethyl, then 3 chloro butuenoid.
So while naming this, you always have to put the alkyl
first.
Right?
Yes. First, we always write alkyl.
Thank you.
While naming the alkyl groups, you have to take the one as the one which is attached.
Yes, from there you have to start.
Okay.
You have to start from this carbon. What is the name of this one?
So why is it two E? Make it the double bond is no. So like why is it numbered?
Because the double
bond is not like carbon. So I thought we continue the numbering like 1, 2, 3.
No, it's a ring.
Huh? So separate.
The substituents on this carbon.
So is that one?
It's one number.
Why is it one again?
Okay. This is the substituents of this carbon atom. If it is not there, then it is methyl and this part you will write.
Oh, so it's
but it is 2-cyclopropanyl methyl.
So, but won't that become the main thing?
Like no. This is the carbon which attached to this carbon atom. C-O-O-R. This is the R group. Substituents on this R group.
It's one. The
first carbon atom is this, and in this the double bond presented second carbon, 1, 2. Okay.
So sir, the carbon which is in the cyclopropane become considered to be part of the main chain?
No, then it will be one extra carbon, because you count in the main chain and cyclopropyl when you write that carbon.
Then you count the cyclopropyl.
Understood.